Yo guys, in this video, I'm going to be going over how to improve FPS in Season 6. In other words, this video is a genuine FPS boost guide for Fortnite Chapter 2 Season 6. For those of you guys who did not know already, the game Fortnite Battle Royale is getting harder to run by the season. And as we are currently on Chapter 2 Season 6 of Fortnite, the game is by far getting harder to run. With the new map and a lot of new things implemented, it's probably fair to say that our FPS is going to be the worst it's ever been. So you're probably wondering,
Joes, how's this video going to help me?
Well, you see, I have compiled this video to show you the best of the best methods. I have done tons of research on how to improve FPS in Fortnite, and I've compiled the best methods the competitive players use, as well as professional tweakers who tweak PCs for competitive Fortnite players. But I'm going to be doing secret tips that they do for free on this video, so it'd be much appreciated if you left a like and subscribed, but only do these two steps if this video helps you, as it would be much appreciated. And I've spent hours making this video, and leaving a like and subscribing only takes 2 seconds out of your day. But without further being said, let's go over the first method in improving your FPS. So for the first method, I'm going to start off with a really easy one that quite a few people know about, but not that many, and this is to update your Windows settings. So what you guys want to end up doing is navigate to where it says update and security, and then you should see something that says Windows update at the top. By pressing checking for updates, you're manually viewing all the updates that Windows has to offer. This is a huge FPS increase, and not a lot of people actually know about this, but by just updating your Windows updates, it feels as if you're getting a brand new PC over and over again. It's just such a refreshing feeling, and your PC just runs a lot smoother. Now, you guys are probably wondering, how often do you have to do this? Through personal experience, I do my Windows updates roughly about twice a week. It's obviously better to do as many as possible, and there are frequent updates with this. It's obviously not like your driver updates where you have to update them like once a month, but the difference is that these are so frequent, you probably have updates once a week. Moving on to the next method in increasing FPS in Fortnite, this is to navigate over to game mode settings. This is a big one, guys. It should be off, but you want to have it set to on. Right before I do move on to the next setting, you guys need to bear in mind that this is not going to work for everyone. For some systems, it will result in instabilities, but for me personally, this setting increases my FPS in Fortnite. Essentially, what this setting does is prioritizes games and minimizes background tasks. In addition to that setting, you guys want to navigate to your graphics settings. You guys want to make sure you have enabled where it says hardware, accelerated GPU scheduling, and another important setting is the one right below this. Click browse for graphics performance preference, and you guys want to search up Fortnite launcher.exe, just how I've written it, guys. And then once you've hit enter, right click on it and press open file location. So what you're going to want to do is you want to hit where it says Fortnite client Windows 64, just the one I've highlighted, and you guys want to press add. Now for the final thing, you guys want to press on options, select the highest value you see, which in my case is high performance. Not everyone's going to have this because it varies between your graphics card, but select high performance if you do see it. You will need to restart your PC for these effects to take place and close your Windows settings. And this now brings us onto the next method in increasing your FPS in Fortnite. Moving on, we have the next method. That was a bit of a scene change. We are currently recording with OBS. Alright guys, so for this method, you guys want to open up NVIDIA Control Panel. Once you guys have NVIDIA Control Panel, these are currently the best settings as of right now. What you guys want to end up doing is go over to where it says Adjust Image Settings with Preview. You guys want to start off by pressing Use My Preference Emphasizing, and then you guys want to select it to be on Performance. So it will be over here on Balance. You guys want to drag that down to Performance. Now you guys want to press and navigate to where it says Use the Advanced 3D Image Settings, just to secure it, but with the better setting overall. Once you guys have finished doing that, press Apply, but I won't be doing that because, you know, there's no point, and wow, I'm kind of waffling. What am I even doing? Now this moves us onto the best 3D managed settings, or managed 3D settings as you guys like to call it. So what you guys want to do is go over to where it says global settings, and these are the important ones that you guys want to be using. Pause the video, guys, if you want to. I'm just going to give you guys a quick scroll through. Yeah, you guys can pause the video. These are just my settings. Alright, so the one setting that I want to go over is actually something that has caused a lot of controversy. This is the low latency mode. So through personal experimentation, I've actually set this to off, as it doesn't make a huge difference for me. I currently use a GTX 1650, but varying on your specs, there could be a better setting out there. Now, a lot of people actually recommend following this. I recommend putting this on on. On is actually the best setting for good PCs. If you guys have just an average PC and you're getting somewhere between 200 FPS in Fortnite, I would have this on, as you guys probably have decent specs. And for those of you guys who have top of the line PCs, and I mean top of the line, like spec'd out 30 series cards, go over to Ultra. But yeah, guys, I've noticed that there's not really a huge difference between off, on, and Ultra. It's just, if you guys have the better PC, I'd go the extra mile and set this onto on. I wouldn't really recommend Ultra, but as of right now, guys, off and on are really good settings. For the sake of my FPS, guys, I currently use off. So yeah, these are pretty much my settings, which leads us on to the last part. Alright guys, so for the last thing I want to show, this is adjust desktop size and position. Over here guys, it says perform scaling on. If you guys have the option, and only if you do have the option of display, I would navigate over to where it says display and select this. Display is a lot better guys, and you know, it's not the end of the world if you don't have it, it's just it can actually help you. For your scaling mode on your Nvidia control panel, you want to have this on full screen for the best outcome. And then for refresh rate, you guys want to select the highest value you see once again, which I see 144Hz. You guys might have a 360Hz monitor or 240Hz monitor. But once you've done all of these settings guys, you could just exit out once you've applied everything. Okay guys, so this moves us on to the most important FPS boost for this whole video. The method I'm about to go over, I actually did find out from a professional PC tweaker. He's actually tweaked PCs for a lot of competitive Fortnite players. But what you guys want to do for this method, and trust me, you don't want to miss out on this. This one can increase your FPS by so much. And not only just that, it's going to make your CPU run a whole lot smoother. So you guys want to open up an app by the name Task Manager. Or you guys can just right click on your search bar or whatever this is called and then click on Task Manager. Once you guys do have your Task Manager open, you guys want to navigate to where it says Performance. And then over here is a number that says processes. So what processes means guys in short term is a list of running applications and background processes on your system, along with CPU, memory disk, network, GPU, and other resource usage information. Basically, the number of processes is just how much your processor has to manage and kind of work onto. So it's basically just wearing out your CPU and making it do a lot of work that's unnecessary by having a lot of processes. So what we're going to do is make this number reduced by a lot, which will make your CPU run a whole lot smoother. And I know I have 163 processes, but I'm about to change this right now. So in order to make your number of processes go down, you guys want to open up an app by the name Services. Once you guys have Services open, and this is a really big FPS increase, you guys want to look for something by the name SysMain. So we're just going to scroll down guys, and boom, right over here guys, we have found SysMain. This thing right here is absolutely terrible, and you guys want to make sure you've disabled this. So for this right here guys, you want to right click on it, you want to head over to where it says Properties. Now I've already done this guys, you want to make sure the startup type, it should be on automatic, but you want to make sure that it's on disabled for the best FPS performance. Then you want to apply and then press OK. Okay guys, so now that we've got the other method covered up, this moves us on to the final method of the video. This is a really crucial method, and I'll be giving you guys the best settings for Fortnite to ensure that you have the best possible performance. But as we are in Fortnite guys, this gives me a great time to plug in my creator code. Make sure you guys are using supporter creator code JoesHD. But honestly, please use supporter creator code JoesHD, because quite recently I've gotten like the lowest amount of supporters I've ever got. So yeah, if you're not using this creator code, then you are a falafel. But without further being said, I'm going to be moving on to the best settings so you guys can ensure the best possible FPS. Okay, so starting off guys, you want your window mode to be on full screen. Make sure your resolution is 1920 by 1080, but here is a really important step guys. If you guys have been experiencing a lot of hitchbacks to your FPS, I would probably lower this to 1600 by 900. Or if 1600 by 900 isn't good enough, then maybe try 1280 by 720. These are just a way of changing your in-game resolution without having stretch resolution, and that does actually help increase your FPS by quite a lot. For your frame rate limit, I have mine set to 180, but this does vary on your monitor. I've heard a lot of people say one higher than the refresh rate of your monitor and all of that. I personally have this capped to 180, but for you guys it may be different. I would start off by capping this at my monitor's refresh rate, and if you guys think you still want more, then make it a little bit higher. Moving on guys, we have the graphics quality. You want to have everything here set to low. You guys want to have VSync turned off, motion blur off, show FPS on. This is a completely optional setting. And for your rendering mode, this varies on your specs. I personally use DirectX 11. It is actually the best in my opinion, but if you guys have better components in your system, DirectX 12 might be better for you. Performance mode is really great and I would highly recommend it, but unfortunately I have 8GB of RAM, so once again Fortnite did some stupid thing that makes no sense and I can't actually get performance mode anymore. But if performance mode works for you guys, you definitely want to have it on, and make sure you get those bubble wrap builds by putting your meshes set to high. For allow multi-thread rendering, if you guys have 4 or more cores in your CPU, you want to have this set to on, but if you have less than 4 cores, then you guys want to have this setting turned off. For use GPU crash debugging, you guys want to have this set to off because it does just run in the background, taking up a lot of your PC's usage. And then for your latency markers, this is totally up to you, and the last 2 settings can be off. Low latency mode doesn't make that big of a difference guys, but obviously if you want to have this on or on plus boost, it can help you to an extent. Hopefully in this video, I did improve your FPS in Season 6 of Fortnite. And if you guys did actually remember at the start of the video, I said that if this video helps you in any way, it would be much appreciated if you left a like and subscribed. And just the fact that you guys made it this far into the video, I'm pretty sure you wouldn't mind sparing 2 seconds out of your day, leaving a like and subscribing. Also, make sure to turn on post notifications if you guys want to be notified every time I make a video just like this one. And remember guys, you support a creator code JoesHD in the item shop. If you guys show me any proof on my Twitter at HDJoes, I'll be sure to retweet you and even follow you back. So yeah guys, hopefully you did enjoy this FPS boost guide, and I'll see you in the next one. Hey,